There are many ways that you can outpaint an image using a diffusion model. Here's how you can do it using a control net. So when I fire up Automatic1111's WebUI, I'm gonna go ahead and set the textual prompt to basically what this image currently is, and then also what I want the outpainting to be. So if you wanna add a new element, you would wanna go ahead and modify your prompt accordingly. So when outpainting an image with a control net, you can either choose to go in an upward and downward direction or to the left and right. In this example, we're going to go ahead and expand it to both the left and right direction. So I'm going to go ahead and change the width to 1024, and I'm going to increase this batch count to 4. So I have 4 different candidates that I can review here. And since this is a previously generated image, I'm going to go ahead and change the seed value back to a random value. So I have 4 different images I can review. Then all you got to do is go ahead and expand this control net box and then upload an image, or if your browser supports it, to drag and drop it over to this box. And then make sure that is set to enable, and then click on InPaint, and then change the preprocessor to InPaint only plus Llama. And then you can make sure that this control net model is an InPainting control net. Now for the control mode, we're gonna go ahead and change this over to say control net is more important and that we want it to be resize and fill. Now we'll just go ahead and scroll up here and then click generate. Okay, so that just wrapped up, and now we can see there are 4 really good looking images that were expanded using the control net in painting function there. As just a quick additional example, I went ahead and added the term beautiful flowers to the prompt. And as you can see, when the control net expanded this image, it added those to both the left and the right of the subject. Now, I just want to make a couple of quick points here. First is that you can use a generation checkpoint to produce the image. However, though, in painting checkpoints can also work when expanding the image with a control net. Secondly, within the settings of WebUI, you want to make sure that you go down to control net and then change this control net in painting Gaussian blur sigma to something around the neighborhood of 20 to 40. This will ensure that there's no harsh lines in the images as they are expanded in any sort of direction. Otherwise, you will definitely see a noticeable break between the original image and the expanded image. I hope that you guys found this video helpful. If you have any questions, drop a line in the comment section below. Thanks so much for watching, and take care.